Well, we have the brand new information in from the Hurricane Center. The hurricane hunters were up in there overnight and are sending this information back. We do have an intensifying storm. Now, it's still at tropical storm status. It's not a hurricane, but the winds have gone up to 60 miles per hour, and we are starting to see a little bit of a turn with the movement. Instead of due north, it's now starting to head to the north northeast and picking up speed a little bit. It's going to move very quickly. Right now, the center of the storm is about 350 miles or so away from Orlando, but it is expected to make landfall in the Big Bend area. And of course, all of the rain will be wrapping around the storm, which is why we have the flood watch and the 4, 5, 6, even up to 8 inches of rain possible in some of our western areas. We also, of course, need to keep an eye out for that tornado threat, as these little bands inside here, these little rain bands, move very quickly off to the north. We can easily see these little rain wrapped tornadoes spin up very quickly, and oftentimes they're difficult to see because they're wrapped with rain. So it just looks cloudy, gloomy, rainy, and you may not even realize that those winds are spinning inside the cloud. So Polk County is where we're seeing this. We did have some tornadoes this morning reported in the Tampa area with some damage, which is why we need to keep a close eye on this line as it lifts to the north. Heading up into Winter Haven at 444, Dade City just before 5 a.m. We'll keep you posted as that line gets closer to Orange Lake and Sumter counties. Eric?
We are continuing to watch that nasty day that we're going to see ahead, Amy. Let's take you through the next, say, 24 hours or so. This morning, temperatures in the 70s, those heavy downpours moving around. That morning commute's not going to be pretty. Of course, Kimberly Williams is in all morning to keep you up to date on that. This afternoon, the tornadic threat, the heavy downpours, that's going to continue for us. And then overnight tonight into tomorrow, the good news is, as Andrea pulls away, the threat of severe weather comes down. But of course, the afternoon showers and thunderstorms, that's going to continue across Central Florida. So let's take you county by county. Let's start in Lake County, where you're expecting anywhere from 3 to 6 inches of heavy rains. You are, at least for the southern part of the county, under a tornado watch, and we're going to be watching those squalls. Gusts possible up to about 40 miles an hour. Sumter County, for you, it's going to be a rough day with a high risk of tornadoes, at least for Central Florida standards, when a tropical system makes landfall. Wind gusts up to 40 with sustained winds 20 to 30. In Orange County, we're talking about a flood watch in effect for you, of course, watching that tornado threat and gusty winds embedded within these feeder bands. So a rough morning, at least weather-wise.